The Coronado Public Library has launched their summer reading program, Dive into Discovery. I'm Sydney Zor, and I'm here at Coronado Shores to talk a little bit about sand dollars. I've been surfing down here for probably about the past 7 or 8 years, and I've oftentimes seen people taking live sand dollars from the beach. So we want to clear up which ones you can take and which ones should be left for people to enjoy and for the ecosystems to keep on thriving here at Coronado Beach. So sand dollars are a type of flat, burrowing sea urchin, and they're covered in tiny, hair-like spines. And if those spines are still moving, the sand dollar is alive. And these live sand dollars can be dark purple or more brown, whereas when they die, they're whitish or silvery colored and they lose their spines. And those ones are okay to take from the beach for decorations at home or just if you're a shell collector as well.
So these are the ones that you don't want to take because you can see that their small spines are still moving and they're also dark purple in color. So when it's appropriate to take them is when you can't see any spines moving and more likely their spines have all gone off of the sand dollar and they're smooth and they're silvery white or even sometimes they're kind of a yellowish brown gold color.
They actually use their spines when they're alive to move around in the sand and burrow themselves edgewise on their side. So they live in sand dollar beds with several hundred per square yard, and the Monterey Bay Aquarium says there can be actually 625 of them in one square yard. And when the water gets really clear here out at the shores, you can go down to the bottom just past the surf line when the water starts getting around 8 to 12 feet. So it kind of depends on the tide, but you can swim out there if you're surfing or swimming, and you'll be able to see these sand dollars in their beds when the water gets clear. And their hard skeleton makes a large portion of their body inedible, so they don't have very many predators, except for larger sea stars and some types of eel-like fish. Sand dollars eat algae and crustacean larvae with these spines, taking in the food in a small hole on the underside of their bodies. They're actually classified as omnivorous because some of their food is composed of small sea animals rather than just algae. When you see them on the beach, only pick them up out of the water if they're alive for a couple moments just to look at them and then place them back deeper in the water so they can continue to live because they can't survive for more than a few minutes out of the water. Try to place them out past the shallow water where they're likely to get stepped on and place them back on the ocean floor. Dead sand dollars can be taken home for decorations or shell collections, but make sure you leave the live sand dollars in the ocean. Remember that dead sand dollars are usually white or light brown and they don't have moving spines.
And this is an okay time to take them home because as you can see, they're smooth and they're not a purplish color anymore. They're either silvery white like this one or more toward the yellowish brown side. And their spines aren't moving. They have no spines actually because they're dead and they're okay to take home as shells or decorations. And on this one, you can see on the underside, there's a small hole and that's actually their mouth where they take in their food.
People might not think so, but sand dollars actually serve a really vital role in our ocean ecosystems. So next time you're out for a walk or a swim or just enjoying the ocean, take a moment to remember this and enjoy the sand dollars. I'm Sydney Zor. Thanks for diving into Discovery with the Coronado Public Library Summer Reading Program. For more information, visit coronadolibrary.org. We'll see you next time.